If the line touches the circle at one point called tangent. So we'll just see more about that. Non-intersecting line. When a line and a circle have no common point, then it is called a non-intersecting line with respect to the circle. So the first figure doesn't intersect at anywhere. Am I clear, children? Am I clear? The second one, it has two common points, M and N. When a line intersects a circle in such a way that there are two common points, then that line is called secant. That just now we have discussed. Next comes the tangent. This is a new word we are using in this grade 10. When a line touches circle in such a way that they have only one common point, then that line is called a tangent. That common point is called the point of contact. So this line and this line touches a circle at one point, that is P. This is called
tangent.
This is called a tangent. What the point of this point is called?
Tangent. Point.
Common point.
Called the point of contact. Am I clear, children? That point P is called the point of contact. Anyone have doubt with the meaning of a circle and the relation and the few definitions of sector, segment, arc? Anything, children? Any doubt till here?
No, ma'am.
Did you understand the meaning of the relation between a circle and a line, line in a plane?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we move on to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, tangent to a circle. Here, please observe carefully, children. This question, they'll ask for one or two more question. This is very, very important. Just observe this figure. Am I clear? All the tangents of a circle are perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact of the tangent. First, I'll draw a radius. Then I'll draw a XY line. So always remember, all the tangents, what we're taking, it is always perpendicular to the radius through this point of contact, P of the tangent. Am I clear, children? The radius always perpendicular. That's will prove that. We'll see how it is. Am I clear, children? Here you just observe here, this OQ and OP, which is a greater line here. As I said, if OP is perpendicular to XY, so OP is a shorter than OQ, children?
Yes, ma'am.
It is a perpendicular, I can say this is a right angle here. Right, yes, angle, ma'am. Opposite side is a hypotenuse, that is a OQ. Then this OQ is a short, longest side.
Yes, ma'am.
So OP is the radius of the circle and Q is any point on the line XY, which is a tangent to the circle, as OP is the shortest one. Compared to OQ, OP is the shortest line of all the distance of the point O. Just observe, this OP is the shortest distance compared to OQ. Am I clear, children? So OP is perpendicular to XY, hence OP is the perpendicular symbol just we mentioned. Once again, I'll repeat. So always remember this, I'll just take a point Q on XY, I'll join O and Q. So once you join O and Q, you just observe. So this O and Q, I can join the line towards this side also, towards X also. I can join O and R. So if I join even O and R here, that distance, if you check, the distance is always greater compared from O to any point on the XY other than the tangent, if you take, that is the greatest length. Am I clear, children? So OP is the shortest length compared to OQ, or if I don't OR anything, that's why this shortest distance answer perpendicular. That's why when it's perpendicular, when you can say all the tangents of the circle perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Am I clear, children? So this will apply in a sum to solve. This is a one mark question they will ask. Am I clear, children? Any doubt in that?
Yes.
Audible to everyone? So we'll just see how many tangents we can draw to a circle. Okay. Okay, children. How many tangents? For example, you have seen a circle. Here, one tangent I have drawn. Like this. How many tangents you can draw to the circle?
Infinite.
Very
infinite.
We can draw infinite many tangents to the circle. So I can draw. I'll take a. I'll take a line segment or line. I'll just join one here. The other one I'll take. Again, I'll keep on joining like this. The point of contact is only one. Am I clear, children? Am I clear to this one? So like this, I can join many lines. Many tangents will get for a circle. Am I clear, children? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So infinitely many tangents we can draw to the circle. Number of tangents from a point on a circle. There could be only one tangent at one point of contact. So for one point of contact, this only for at P, I can draw only one tangent. If I take here one, if I drawn that at particular point of contact, only one tangent. Am I clear, children? Particular point of contact, I can draw only one tangent. Tangent could not be drawn from any point inside the circle. So will you be able to join the tangent from the inside the circle?
No, ma'am.
There could be only two tangents to a circle from any point outside the circle. This I'll explain, children. So I'll take a point C. So from this C, I can draw only two tangents. There could be only two tangents to a circle from any point outside the circle. If I take any point outside the circle from this point C, I can draw only two tangents, that is CA and CB. Am I clear, children? So from any point outside the circle, we can able to draw only two tangents, that is CA and CB from this exterior point C. Am I clear, children? Any doubt in this third point?
No, ma'am.
So now I'm going to prove these two tangents to be, I said there could be two tangents to a circle from any point outside the circle C. So according to this figure, the outside point is C, and this particular point, if I call OA, OA and OB are two radii, and point of contact A and B are two tangents here. CA and CB are two tangents. Now I'll explain these two. Here we got two triangles, so children. So if I call this center as O, which are two triangles I got here?
AOC and BOC.
Very good. Here two triangles I got, AOC and BOC. So now I'm going to prove these two triangles are congruent. Will you be explained that these two triangles are congruent, anyone?
Yes.
In these two triangles, AOC and BOC, OA is equal to OB?
OC is equal to C.
Why? What's the reason?
Radius
of the circle.
Radius of the circle.
This OC is a common point?
Yes, ma'am.
Common line? Yes. OC is common in both the triangle?
Yes, ma'am.
Here, angle OAC and angle OBC are right angle?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So, we can prove these two triangles are congruent?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what is the rule we have applied here? Which rule?
RHS.
Yes.
RHS
rule we have applied. According to RHS rule, triangle AOC and triangle BOC are congruent. When these two triangles are congruent, then CA is equal to CB?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear, children? When these two triangles are congruent, then these two sides are also equal. Therefore, the two tangents drawn from a point outside, so those two triangles are always equal in length. Am I clear, children? I'll explain once again. Here I've drawn two tangents CA and CB from one point which is outside the circle. So now I'm going to prove these two lines are equal, that is CA and CB. So when I join this, I'll join OC here. I did not mark here O here. Just consider center as O. So we got two triangles. Now I'm going to prove these two triangles are congruent. So here angle A is 90 degree, angle B is 90 degree. So angle A is equal to angle B, both are equal. Then here OC, the line segment OC is common to both the triangle. And here OA and OB are equal radii. Both are, because we know that from the center to the boundary, radius are equal. The distance is equal. So OA is equal to OB according to the RHS rule. So what RHS rule says, so this hypotenuse should be equal to both and it should be right angle and any one side should be given. Either see here, side angle, side also we can see here. Tangents we are proving now, sorry. So right angle, it is right angle and opposite sides are equal and any one side is equal. That is nothing but as RHS rule. Am I clear, children? RHS rule says the angle should be right, triangle should be a right angle and hypotenuse should be equal. So right angle, opposite sides are hypotenuse, that should be equal and any one side, in the remaining two sides, any one side should be given. So that is nothing but as RHS rule. So from that we proved triangle AOC and triangle BOC are congruent. So it is based on RHS rule. When these two triangles are congruent, then CA is equal to CB. CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Am I clear, children? Am I clear? This is
small
proof. They may ask for 2 marks. Prove that. Same statement they'll give. So prove that there could be two tangents at a point outside circle. Then prove that the tangents are equal. They may ask. So it's easy to prove that, no, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone have doubt in the proving two tangents are equal? Here, no. Two tangents are drawn from the external point C. As the tangent is perpendicular to the radius, it is formed the right angle triangle. So what I explained just now, here it is in conclusion. So triangle AOC and triangle BOC, just now I explained, it is our congruent right angle triangle. Hence AC is equal to BC. So tangents are equal. Any doubt in proving these two tangents are equal, children? Do anyone have doubt in this?
No, ma'am. Ma'am, so we just have to show that they should be perpendicular to the radius.
Here, we are not showing perpendicular radius, dear. Here, we are going to prove that AC is equal to BC. Am I clear? Here, yes, what do we need to prove is, prove that when two triangles are congruent, tangents are equal. Am I clear? Here, yes, what we are going to prove is, the tangents drawn from outside a point outside the circle are equal. Am I clear? The tangents drawn, two tangents drawn from a point C, which are equal. So we need to prove that here two tangents are equal. Am I clear here?
Yes, ma'am.
Do anyone have doubt in proving that two tangents are equal?
No, ma'am.
So tomorrow, I'll just give only this one, this particular point in the classwork. Here, I just gave a statement. Triangle AOC and triangle BOC are congruent. That is because of RHS rule. Before this, you need to write what I explained orally, that congruence one, you need to write, then show this one. Am I clear, children?
Congruence you should write, ma'am.
Yes, here you need to prove that. Here you need to prove that OA is equal to OB equal radii. OC is equal to OC, comma, then triangle OAC is equal to triangle OBC, both equal to 90 degree. Therefore, triangle AOC and triangle BOC are congruent. The reason is RHS. Therefore, CA is equal to CB, that is CPCT. Am I clear, yes, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So, what did not discuss in today's class? Today, I introduced the word tangent. Tangent, how many tangents we can draw to the circle?
Infinite.
Infinite tangents we can draw. So, one thing you remember, from the center to the tangent, point of contact is always perpendicular. Am I clear, children? All the tangents of a circle are perpendicular to the radius of the point of contact to the tangents. So, based on this concept, exercise 15.1, circle is a 15th chapter, only two exercises are there. So, that will finish it off. Okay, children? So, exercise 15.1, so tomorrow's homework, only fill in the blanks they gave. Question number 1, 2 and 3 will find out the answer. Only fill in the blanks, and based on this perpendicular, we need to prove that. Am I clear, children? Easy questions. So that you take it as homework.
Should I fill in the blanks in the classwork?
No, dear. Tomorrow, again, when the next class, I'll ask these questions, you should be able to answer. Okay?
Okay.
Fill in the blanks, don't write. But multiple choice questions are there that you show the proof how you have got the answer for that. Am I clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Be honest in answering. So, tomorrow's class, you need to practice all these definitions. I'm going to ask all these definitions. Okay, children? In the classwork, I'll send this to PDF. Remember, children, this introduction part, you know, try to what is polygon. This is not just for the introduction purpose I typed here. This particular two pages you have to write. First three pages you have to write this. From the circle concept we are starting now. From here, you start writing in the classwork all the definitions. Am I clear?
Okay.
Again, I'll repeat. From this circle, don't write the introduction part. From this circle heading, you start writing in the classwork all these definitions. Then fill in the blanks. You just by understanding these definitions, you fill in the blanks. Then there are some multiple choice questions are there. From question number 2 and 3 multiple choice questions. That one you solve and write the answer. Am I clear, children?
Exercise 10.1, question number 1, 2, 3 should write, ma'am.
Yes, exercise 10.1, question number 1, 2 and 3. We'll just recall what we have learnt in today's class. Today's class, we have learned the definition of circle and other meaning. This meaning of a center, radius, chord, diameter, circumference, arc. These are the things we just recall from our previous class. And the sector, segment and tangent. That these are the three things we introduced in this year. No, last year also we explained sector and segment. The sector and segment I explained in the previous class, that is grade 9. So, this year, I'm introducing the word tangents.
Tangents.
Am I clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, do anyone have any doubt in today's class? And again, we proved that two tangents drawn from a point which is exterior of the circle are equal. That particular things we proved that you are going to prove this one. So, after this point, here two tangents are drawn from the external point C. As the tangent is perpendicular to the radius, it is formed the right angle triangle. After this, you need to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Then two tangents, that is AC and BC, are equal. Am I clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Already we have learned how to prove the congruency of triangles. So that concept you have to apply and you have to write the proper statement for this one. Am I clear, children?
Yes,
draw this figure. After this statement, prove that this AC is equal to BC.